Well, we've been wanting to increase the footprint of bystanders throughout the country. And we've been fortunate to have funding from the local area foundations to support training of CPR in the seventh grade student population in Westmoreland County. It's been kind of a campaign that we've worked with the Community Foundation and others to try to fund to basically train as many people as we can in CPR. It's an interesting story. Dr. Peter Saffer, who's known as the father of CPR, did a study funded by the National Institute of Health to prove the optimal time to train CPR. And he discovered that it was in fact seventh grade. The seventh graders have the best retention, they have the strength to be able to do CPR, and what we've learned more importantly is they still like their family and they go home and share their newfound knowledge. They're not too cool yet not to go home and share the knowledge with their family. And so the national average for every kit that we distribute, four people are trained, the student and three more people. What's more interesting though is when the students challenge each other to train more people. And so this school, for example, challenged the students to go home and train 10 additional people. So that's definitely a return on investment for the Community Foundation. You know, the program has been in place. The American Heart Association is very strategic, and we worked with the Laerdal Corporation to design this kit that has everything you need for to learn CPR, choking, and AED placement in about 23 minutes. The kits go home with the students, and they can then share the information. It's designed to take the fear out of CPR. So in other words, you can take it back out and refresh yourself in 23 minutes. Unfortunately, as a not-for-profit, we require funding to take the program. So we look to our individuals and foundations within the communities to help to fund the initiative. And we've been fortunate here in Westmoreland to have the support of the Dominion Foundation, the Snee Reinhardt Foundation, of course, the Greensburg Fund of the Community Foundation, and the Community Foundation Now and Forever Fund. And I think it appeals to the funders because they know that it's a pass it forward. So the students learn the skill, which they retain for their entire lifetime, but they also take it home and teach others how to perform CPR.
County area.
This particular campaign is. Westmoreland, as you know, has both urban and rural. So it's incredibly important. You know, if someone in the urban area has sudden cardiac arrest, your chances are very close to being close to the hospitals or care. But if you're out in the rural area, it can take as many as 20 minutes to get in for care. So it's incredibly important in the areas with mixed geography to make sure that people know CPR. So we do this throughout the country, but I had a particular passion about Westmoreland because of the challenges here in the community. Well, we just recently received funding from the North Hills Passavant Hospital Foundation in their community outreach, and they'll be training six school districts in the North Hills in the fall. We've had a wonderful relationship with the EQT Foundation, and they have, in fact, funded us for the last 4 years in rural Kentucky, West Virginia, Ohio, and now a little bit into Pennsylvania. And at the end of this grant period, which will start in the fall, they will have trained over 100,000 citizens in CPR, which is phenomenal. Well, the help, I think, most importantly, is the funding to get it, but most importantly, to talk to other people about the importance of CPR. I mean, once you have the experience of knowing that you can learn CPR in 22 minutes, and can share it with others, it becomes less daunting. You know, we all went to class when we were younger and had 3 or 4 hours of training, and a lot of people don't have time to do that, and this is our way of making sure that it's better to do something than not do something at all. And we think it's important for people to spread the word that you can in fact do this. The kits are available online to be sold retail. And of course, we at the Heart Association attempt to raise funds to do charitable programs like the school program here at Greensburg-Salem Middle School.